I wanna introduce you to my kinfolks, to my old friends, to the house and the pines where the road ends.
Hi guys, welcome back. A week later, but I'm back. This just took longer for me to edit. And shout out to all the vloggers who vlog, because like that is a lot of work. Anyways, I hope you enjoy.
Good morning. So I thought I would film like a day in the life, you know, during this quarantine crisis. And I'm going to quickly run out to the store before I start work and grab some fish because tomorrow is Good Friday. And I grew up always eating fish and bread on Good Friday. So my mom is Bahamian, and I don't know where she got it from or her family got it from. We always did that. So I'm going to grab some fish. And they say that the morning time is the best time to go to the stores because it's less contamination. And then when I get back, I have some video calls I have to attend to. So you guys can hang out with me for a little bit.
Payments up to 120
okay, so... I'm going to head to the store now to get the fish, and I have my mask because now they're like requiring you to, you know, have these things, and I have my box of gloves, so we're good to go.
And I know we just met. I want to introduce you to my kinfolks, to my old friends, to the house and the pines where the road ends. Take you to my hometown.
This store right here, this store traumatized me as a child. It's filled of Caribbean people that know exactly the type of meat and fish they want. So as an adult, it's necessary to come here if you want fresh fish.
I have some video conferences. I have two video conferences today, and I have actually a lot of work I need to do for my job. I am lucky enough to be transitioned to a work from home temporarily. So I'm still working.
So I'm finished with work for the day, and this is basically how we season our fish. This is a goat pepper that mi madre is chopping up, and we are going to distribute this over the fish. She will add some salt to it, and it's going to look like a lot of salt, but it's going over four fish, and this makes sure that everything is seasoned really well and tastes yummy.
As I said, I grew up eating fish and bread on Good Friday. So we have our red snapper and we have some Johnny cake. I can't explain to y'all how happy I am. I'm so happy that I'm going to eat this with my hands. I don't need a fork getting in the way. So if you're offended, don't watch. Today's the day that God was crucified on the cross for us, for our sins. And I am so thankful. That was good. Let me move this out the way so I can talk to you guys. So, like I said, today's Good Friday. And that's the day that Jesus was crucified by the Pharisees and hung on the cross. And on that day, it was finished. I was thinking, and I know that this question gets thrown out a lot, of why believe in God? You know, there's so much bad things happening. Why would you believe in something like that? And I think the answer to this question is really simple. For me, why I still believe? It's really quite simple. If you're in this faith or a believer, right? You have a personal relationship with God. You are letting him know your fears, your stressors, you know, the goals you have for yourself. And there's a back and forth of what you talk about. This sounds crazy, I know, but I'm just being open and transparent and going to answer the question. So for people of the faith, right, usually the reason why you can continue believing in this faith, even when you had, you know, trials and stuff like that, is because there are unexplainable things that will happen in your life that you know you can only tie it back to God. For example, I remember being in college and I was taking a placement test and I only had 3 tries. I failed twice. Granted, I wasn't studying, okay? But we're not talking about that. So after the second attempt, I called my grandma. Now remember, grandma is OG, okay? She's a commander in the army, okay? And I'm like, grandma, please, pray for me, I'm gonna fail, I'm gonna jump out of college, I need you to pray, please. And so my grandma, being the sweet angel that she is, but who also told the truth, kind of checked me and was like, you need to pray for yourself. I was like maybe 1 year into being a Christian at that time. So I'm like, grandma, this is serious business. I need you to talk to your boss on my behalf, okay? You higher up. And so she did. She did pray for me. And the next day I took the test and I passed the test. Now, yes, some will say, oh, it's luck. I'm going to account it to my faith. So when you have people who are like, why do you believe? It's because something has happened in your life that makes you tie it back that this can only be because of my faith. For example, you might have in your church, someone spoke something over your life that comes to pass in a month or two or whatever, or someone told you about a dream you had that you didn't tell anyone else about, you know? So when you have these things that happen, it keeps you believing in your faith. The same way for people who go to like, what's those things called? Psychics and stuff like that. They keep going back because the person has told them something that is valuable to their life or something that was true in their life and they believe in it. It's the same thing for us. So I hope I answered that question of like, why believe? You believe because you have things that have happened into your life that you can only account to your faith. And I've had other bigger things that happened where I'm like, I haven't told a soul this, but someone has said it. So I'm rambling now, so I'm going to be quiet. So happy Good Friday, happy Easter, happy Resurrection Sunday for all my saints. And I will see you on my next video.